that's
third one.
Yeah, that you're absolutely dead on when you use that time frame. We've got sitting here an acupuncturist who, in fact, has been working in a hospital setting here in Chicago at Mercy for 6 years. And so, you know, part of the purpose of this conversation is to get doctors talking to doctors and doctors talking to acupuncturists and acupuncturists talking to doctors and be able to learn from other people's experiences so that we kind of accelerate the integration and the collaboration. And I just wanted to get, because all my experience in hospitals has been in China, whereas Marie Mulcahy, who is an acupuncturist here in Chicago, has had a good bit of experience at Mercy, and I'd like her to give some feedback to some of the concerns that you've had and see what her experience has been like.
Thanks,
Frank.
That'd be great.
Hi. I wanted to say that I think your main point of concern is a point very well taken of the question of cost. That's very true. The program that I run is a program for breast cancer survivors. We call it Whole Women, Whole Health, and acupuncture is one of the facets of that program. We also offer massage, and we offer yoga classes and meditation and nutrition classes as well. We were brought into the hospital setting because it was a request from the patients. There was a desire for them to have more, and that's how we arrived. And because of the grant, we were able to offer these services for free, which makes a huge difference. Now, I'm in the position every year, of course, of trying to re-engage the foundation that funds us and get those funds over and over again. So we're always looking for hooks and ways to make it more appealing to them and to expand the program. One of the things we did a few years ago was to make it mandatory for residents on their internal medicine rotation to come in and observe the acupuncture clinic to get some education for me and to have their questions answered. And it's in that setting that I've been able to see that really it's just an information gap. Because quite honestly, the debate is over. And you know, although the bulk of research has happened in China, MD Anderson, Memorial Sloan Kettering, we have all been conducting really successful trials, rigorous and complete trials that put us on the other side of the debate. And so really I think it's a question of closing that information gap, and that's one of the ways I'm doing it in my practice.